In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My dear brothers and sisters, I welcome every one of you for today's Gospel reflection. We are on 4th of November, Thursday. And today's Gospel of Luke, chapter 15, verses from 1 to 10. My dear brothers and sisters, today's Gospel passage speaks about two accusations of the Pharisees and the scribes against Jesus, that he is always friend with the sinners and goes for a dinner with sinners. These are the two accusations made by the Pharisees and scribes. And the Gospel passage begins with a sentence saying that the sinners were all drawing near to Jesus. Jesus becomes a center of attraction for the sinners because in him they see something very different what they were not able to find in other people. And therefore, the sinners were very much attracted towards the message of Jesus because the message of Jesus had compassion, mercy and forgiveness. And we know that Jesus is an embodiment of God's love, mercy, forgiveness and compassion. And that's the reason why naturally the sinners were coming very close to Jesus, because they were able to feel something very gentle in Jesus, something very unique in the very personality of Jesus, because the entire community was sidelining people, entire society was segregating people and breaking or putting barriers between the people. But we see in the very person of Jesus, those barriers have been removed by forgiveness. The Gospel, we see, according to Luke chapter 15 is something very unique in the Gospel of St. Luke, because it is called as a Gospel within a Gospel. It is called as a Gospel within a Gospel because this chapter specifically speaks about the entire message of Jesus in a very brief, or to say, it is a distill of Jesus' message, or the Gospel of Jesus. And therefore, what is the good news that Jesus proclaimed can be summarized very beautifully and very uniquely in the chapter of 15 according to the Gospel of Luke. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, this is the great love manifested in the very person of Jesus. We see that Jesus mingling with these sinners and sharing their meals with them. And this is the reason why the parable especially teaches that God is a loving, he is patient, he is merciful and a forgiving God. He is so eager to be merciful. God is ready to forgive. His anger is for a moment, but his mercy is for a lifetime. It's what Psalm says. And therefore, this is the entire centrality of the Gospel message, that God is loving, God is forgiving, God is merciful, God is patient, God is waiting in patience. What a beautiful message that we can take from the chapter 15. And this passage is very, very unique for us, because every one of us are sinners. Every one of us are sinners, and therefore we are in need of God's message of love in our life. My dear brothers and sisters, this passage from the Gospel of Luke speaks about the self-righteousness of the one community of people, the Pharisees and the scribes. On the other side, we see the sinners who are longing to receive God's mercy. Self-righteousness, what the Pharisees claim for themselves, is a sign of irritation, because God knows everything. God knows everything in our heart. And that is the reason why we see that Jesus is always with the sinners, because God sees our inner heart. Man may appear to show that he is self-righteous, but no one can deceive God. God knows our inner thoughts. God knows our inner motivations. And therefore, Christianity is not about man seeking God. Christianity is all about a holy God seeking a sinful man. And that is how we see God is very much available. And He goes on beyond the lost sheep. He goes beyond the sinners. And He calls sinners for repentance and calls them for righteousness with Him. And therefore, this is the great message that gives us hope for us. Because everyone are fallen short of our own weakness. We are all sinners in our own way. There is no one righteous in this world. We are in the path of righteousness. And still we carry a lot of sinfulness, a lot of weakness in our life. And God's mercy is a great strength and hope for us. And therefore, trusting in the mercy of God, trusting in the very heart of Jesus that is longing to forgive people, the readiness of God to embrace the sinner is a hope for the present generation who have gone away from Jesus, who have gone away from holiness, who have gone away from the church. The Lord is compassionate and is inviting every one of us to come to Him. We also see such an image Jesus will further going to develop in the very gospel, in the following in the gospel of Luke, the parable of the lost sheep, the parable of the lost coin, and the parable of the lost son. These are the parables that speaks about the mercy of God and God patiently waiting for our return. And therefore, such a welcoming sign is an open welcome to all of us, that everyone who comes with true remorse for sin and asking God for forgiveness, God is ready to forgive. And that is the time we see that Jesus always makes a good use of an opportunity whenever He encounters a sinner. Whenever there is a meal offered to Him, Jesus makes use of those occasions to draw attention of the sinners. For example, when He went to the house of Matthew, the tax collector sinners were all gathered there. And Jesus, by welcoming Matthew, welcomes every one of them. And that is the message that today I need to take home, that our God is a forgiving God and He is ready to forgive all our sin when we come with true repentance. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, what today is in need is that we need to take a message that in salvation and in forgiveness, it is always the initiative of God. God take the first step in bringing back the lost soul. And therefore, God is sending every one of us to bring back the lost sheep back home, back to God's holiness. So today I experience the mercy of God, and therefore I have become an instrument of God to show that mercy in this world. So let us forgive one another. Let us be more kind to people who wrong us. Let us also acknowledge that our weakness is reflected in others. As people commit wrongdoings, it is not something which not uniformly carried, but everyone bears the weakness of human nature, and therefore everyone are possible to commit sin. That possibility also is in me, it's also in every one of us. So what we need is that a heart that tolerates, the heart that is able to forgive, the heart that is able to patiently wait for their return, the heart that is full of love like Jesus. And therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, let me take two things in our mind. One, I need to self-evaluate myself. I have to introspect my life. I have to examine my own conscience every day. What are the sins that I have done? What is the wrongdoing that I have done that are against the commandment of God, that are against the love of Jesus? And let us come out of it. Self-evaluation is the best way one can initiate to come out of one's sinful way of life. And Jesus very much appreciates that. And feeling remorse for our sin. What is the first condition where to feel repentance or seeking forgiveness? It's one's remorse for one's sin and one feeling sorry about it. That is the first thing Jesus looks at. When the moment when we feel sorry for our sin, Jesus takes the first step to forgive us. Second, my dear friend, let us reconcile with God. Sin separates us. Reconciliation is very much needed to bond that broken relationship what caused by sin. So let us be more like Jesus welcoming. Let us also reconcile, as I reconcile with Jesus, let me also reconcile with my brothers and sisters, so that our life becomes more meaningful and joyful. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
I wish you all a blessed day. God bless you.